Welcome back. You're watching 10 News. The mining tax promised big things, but it could be proving to be a big blunder by the Gillard government. A shortfall in its revenue has put a very dark cloud over the budget surplus, but the Treasury is still counting on it to deliver. Paul Bongiorno reports.
The Treasurer was counting on the mining tax to raise close to $4 billion. The mid-year review slashed that in half. But at least the prospect of some revenue is still there.
There is volatility in any revenue source.
Now the High Court has agreed to hear a challenge that could wipe out the entire tax. Even before that, Access Economics believes the budget is already in deficit to the tune of $4.5 billion.
You could still get a surplus, but you'd need to do more than the government has already done.
We stand by the figures and we're on track to deliver a budget surplus.
And that's important because it makes way for the Reserve Bank to cut interest rates.
If the Reserve Bank cuts, that won't be a sign of Australia's economic strength. That will be a sign of general economic weakness.
What a ridiculous thing to say. What an offensive thing to say.
What's he actually want? Does he want interest rates to go up? Well, he's got the track record.
And it's not only Labor's taxes in the firing line. Leaked Treasury costings of the Coalition's plans have found they'll cost business $5 billion in the first year. On your bike, Treasury, as far as Mr. Abbott's concerned.
I don't think that the government should be misusing Treasury analysis in this way.
Joe Hockey says Treasury's assumptions are wrong.
They're factually incorrect. They're grossly inaccurate.
The government says Mr. Hockey doesn't like Treasury because it has a habit of catching him out. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.